Even if you were unfamiliar with her name, it would be hard to find someone who did not recognize one of her films. The Golden Globe-winning actress most recently appeared in Mary Poppins Returns in 2018 and Nanny McPhee back in 2005, but more importantly, the actress also gave a small insight into how she maintains her health. Talking about her delight at being involved within the Mary Poppins sequel a few years back, Angela said, "I so enjoyed Bedknobs and Broomsticks all those years ago, so being in Mary Poppins Returns is a real treat. I feel full of energy and I certainly don't feel 93. I like a glass of wine and take a lot of vitamins, perhaps that keeps me going." Although it seems trivial, the Mayo Clinic has explained in the past that drinking a glass of red wine does actually have some health benefits, in moderation of course. The site explains that the alcohol and certain antioxidants that are present within red wine may help to prevent coronary artery disease, a severe condition that could lead to heart attacks. Vitamin D supplements, the bathroom habit that could mean you've taken too much, although the links between the two are unclear. The Mayo Clinic states that part of the benefit is that antioxidants in red wine may increase levels of good cholesterol, known as high-density lipoprotein, HDL. The increase of this good cholesterol then protects against bad cholesterol buildup, which minimizes cholesterol deposits that can lead to clogged arteries. The Mayo Clinic goes on to explain that it is an ingredient known as resveratrol that helps to prevent damage to blood vessels. This comes from the skin of grapes, and because red wine is fermented with grape skins longer than white wine, it contains more resveratrol. Despite evidence, far more research is needed into the benefits of resveratrol on the lowering of inflammation and blood clotting. Pfizer booster shot, the unexpected side effect after third dose, inside dementia breakthrough, the daily food to eat that strongly reduces the risk of decline, latest Omicron, a specific pain is occurring in patients struck by the variant, doctor's update, expert advice. In addition to wine and vitamins, Angela has credited her grandfather's genes as a part of her youthful existence. In another interview she said, "I've never been particularly aware of my age. It's like being on a bicycle, I just put my foot down and keep going. I never look at my face and think, God, you're getting old, or think of running out of steam." Hereditary youth is another debated factor within scientific research. In one study published by researchers in Rotterdam stated that they had found a gene that specifically affects how old people look. "This is the first gene we have found for perceived age, and this single gene has an effect of 2 years," explained Manfred Kaiser, professor of forensic molecular biology at Erasmus Medical Center in Rotterdam. "We know there are others out there. We are just at the beginning. Variations of one gene, called MC1R, was more common in those who looked old for their age. In order to check the validity of results, other studies were conducted, one in the UK and another in the Netherlands. Scientists looked at how the gene might work but were unable to find out how the gene affects perceived age. However, the research is critical in understanding why some people look younger for their age." After celebrating her 96th birthday back in October of this year, thousands of adoring fans took to social media to celebrate Angela, with some commenting on how good the actress looks. Author Paul Rigby claimed, "Happy birthday Angela Lansbury, still a hottie at 96. Despite all the speculation, it seems that one simple way of aging well is to simply enjoy life, not dwelling too much on your age." In addition, Age UK provides 10 tips on how to age better. Watch what you eat and drink, look after your teeth, stay active, make the most of your doctor, get a vitamin boost, take care of your feet, sort out your sleep, take tests, stay in touch with others, give up smoking.